So in this video, we want to go over how to conduct an independent sample t-test. And an independent sample t-test is going to take one score that we've got, one variable, and see if it's significantly different by a dichotomous nominal variable. Now, dichotomous means that we've got only two levels. If it's got three or more, you're going to want to run an ANOVA instead. So in this case, we're going to compare math test scores by gender. So before we do that, we want to check our assumptions of the independent sample t-test. The first assumption is that the math test scores are normally distributed. So we'll go to Analyze, Nonparametric Tests, One Sample KS Test. And we'll want to check to see if our math test scores are normally distributed. Hit OK. And here are the results of this One Sample KS Test. The results are not significant, which means that the scores are not or are normally distributed. If the results were significant, we would have a not normally distributed score. So that assumption is out of the way. Next, we'll actually go to the second assumption, which is equality of variance. What that means is essentially we want the variability of our math test scores to be the same for both of our categorical variables, for a nominal variable there. So to do that, we'll actually just run the independent sample t-test. So here we'll put our math test scores there. And then in this case, we're going to look at by gender. And we've got values of 1 for male, 2 for female. And then we'll just go ahead and hit OK. Now here are the results. Now right here is the Levine's test. And this is going to tell us if our math test scores are equal in variance by gender. So again, like the KS test, we want this to be non-significant to meet the assumption. If it was significant, we can still run our t-test, we just have to interpret something else. So since we have non-significance here, we can actually interpret the t-test like normal. So here are the results of the t-test. We've got a t of negative 3.752 and a p-value of less than 0.001. So in this case, our math test scores are significantly different by gender. And if we look at the means, the males tended to have lower test scores than females. So we can conclude that the t-test results were significant and males had significantly lower scores than females. Now, if the Levine's test was significant, you would instead interpret this bottom row here, where equality of variance is not assumed. And this would be called the Welch's estimate for the t-test. It's interpreted just the same way. It just calculates the statistics slightly different in order to compensate for the non-equality of variance.